the state should start to look inwards for alternative source of funding if they are really serious in diversifying their economy and place little or no reliance on monthly allocation from the center, which is becoming or forthcoming. It is important to re-emphasize once again that only members of CIJN are backed by law to be appointed the chairman of the Federal and State Internal Revenue Service. Also, only our members have statutory mandate to engage in tax practice. This clarification becomes very apt now that the office of the chairman of FRS is vacant, so that government will not make a mistake of appointing a quack to the position, thereby contravening the law of the land.
The inevitability of taxation as a tool for economic transformation cannot be overemphasized, most especially when resources needed to carry out developmental projects are scarce and inadequate to cover all the areas requiring attention. Furthermore, our country's dependence on revenue from oil over the years has worsened the situation. This accounts for government's efforts in recent times to check the tide by encouraging productive activities in other sectors of the economy. There is no better time to do so than now, considering the volatility of oil prices, which has made it even more imperative for diversification of the national revenue scope.